I just haven't had time to edit and get it up because, as y'all know, I started school, and I gotta give y'all the full spill on that. I'm gonna have to update y'all, but yeah. Hold on, I'm trying to turn the heat up. It's cold, but yeah, I gotta give y'all the whole spill on that situation. But right now, I'm just headed to the bank, and I'm still talking a little funny because I gotta get used to having this piercing right here. I've been thinking about taking it out because I can't eat, but I was like, you know what, it is fine because I'm losing weight. So me and my family, we decided to go on like a weight journey and see who could lose the most weight in the next 15 days. So from today, January 15th, all the way to the 30th, we gonna see who can lose the most weight. So everybody had to weigh in this morning. I'm the only one who weighed in though, because you know, your girl is serious about this weight loss. But yeah, so I did that. Y'all, I'm huge. I'm gonna have to make a whole weight loss video. I said I was gonna do it like last week, and then I just got caught up and I just forgot. So I need to do that probably this week. I'm gonna film it and then tell y'all what I'm gonna be doing and all that good jazz. But yeah, so right now I'm just headed to the bank, like I mentioned. My hair, I hate this wig. I need to give me another wig. I hate this little short wig. I'm gonna give me another one. I need to fill y'all in on that. Matter of fact, I'm gonna go ahead and fill y'all in. So basically what happened with that, you know what, no, I'm not gonna fill y'all in. Y'all gonna get that in like another video. I'm gonna do like a chit chat. Y'all, my ball. Thank you. I like the whole white countertops and then the white cabinet. I like that.
It's pretty. It's really pretty. They
didn't even
break
off
these
kind of things. Okay, I'll go through your wife. No, you're fine. I know some people don't like to be on video, so I'm like, ah. It's actually 2 hours away, but I gotta go get her, and it's only an hour and a half from her. So yeah, oh my goodness, y'all, please get out of the way. So I'm running behind. It's 10:30. I gotta be there at 1, but I gotta go get her. It is kind of like off the way to get her, and I'm 40 minutes from her, but hopefully I can get to her by 11. yeah. Even if I get to her by hopefully I can get, I can get back to her by 11:30. And then so I'm not really running late. I was just trying to leave like mad early. But yeah, so I'm not really running late. I'm running late for the time that I wanted to leave. So yeah, I'm just headed there. Y'all, I woke up this morning and had the worst like panic attack. Like, I didn't film yesterday because I went to the hospital. I went to the ER because out of nowhere when I woke, like, first of all, I was just like exhausted and like tired, like super sleepy. And when I had got up, I was just like, first of all, I check my temperature every day. Bad thing to do, people do not do that. But I just check me and Moo's temperature every morning and throughout the day because, you know, Corona's going out, whatever. And we already had it once. So I just checked my temperature, and when I checked it, it said 96. And so, but our thermometer is probably off because Moo just throws it around and does the most with it. But I said it was 96 or whatever. And y'all know looking up stuff is the worst thing you can do. I looked it up, and it was like, oh, you're, I can't even remember what it said. But basically, like, my temperature was too low or whatever. So I started panicking, and then my heart started racing, and then I got dizzy, and I was just, like, tripping. But I was just mainly focused on how tired I was. Like, I was just super sleepy. I'm like out of it, and I'm like, what the heck is going on? So I just ended up going to the ER to make sure like everything was fine, make sure like all my levels was fine as far as like blood work and all this stuff, and everything came back perfect. My EKG came back perfect. She was like, you can go see your primary care doctor and see if they'll just hook you up on like a heart monitor for a few days to make sure everything's fine. And she was like, but from what we see, everything is fine with you. And I was like, okay then. So I felt like reassured. Then this morning, y'all, I didn't go to sleep till like 3 or 4 in the morning because I was working on schoolwork. First of all, that's a lot of my problems, stress. Stress is like a huge problem with me, as well as like, usually anything that's wrong with me, like if I'm sick or anything, it's because I'm like stressed out, like over, like I've been overworking myself. So that's what it was, like stress. That's what it is. It can cause you to have heart palpitations, all types of stuff. Stress can. So with that being said, last night I had went to sleep around 3 or 4 in the morning because I was working on schoolwork, because that's something I really want to get done. And ever since I signed up for the school, I had did some of the work, like maybe like 2 pages, but I hadn't really had time because I'd be happy, because when I have Moo wants to do the most all day. And then also I just be really busy throughout the day. So with I worked on that like a lot last night, not a whole lot as much as I thought I had, but like I had worked on that last night. And so I ended up falling asleep like 3 or 4, and then Nye came banging on my door at like 9 this morning, and it like startled me, and I'm like, who the heck? So I like jumped up fast with her because I thought it was like the apartment people, and I'm like, it's Sunday, why the heck are y'all even in the building? I ain't did nothing, what the heck is y'all banging on my door for? So I went and opened the door or whatever, and I don't know if that like just triggered me to be anxious or what, I don't know. But like after that, I just could not breathe. Like I was struggling to catch my breath. I was like, like I was literally trying so hard to catch my breath. Like it was just not working. So I jumped in the shower. I still couldn't catch my breath. So then I got out of the shower, and then I jumped back in the shower, and I was like a little more calm, but my heart was still racing because like I was anxious. So then I had what did I do? I just sat down on the bed and I started watching the worship that I usually watch. If y'all don't know, Elevation Church, Pastor Stephen Burdick. And then I just started calming down, and now I'm pretty calm. So I just gotta figure out how to get this under control without medication. I do not want to be on the medicine. So, okay, y'all. So we are in QC. If y'all don't know what QC is, it's in the south. Isn't it in the north too? No, they got Wawa in the north.
Ain't this one?
No, it's south. Girl. Okay, we're not gonna talk about her. But it's not. Okay, y'all. We gonna. Just excuse my baby. She a little slow.
We'll try this again.
Yeah. Okay. But yes, we're about to get us. They mean it's required before order pickup.
Nope.
Jesus Christ.
No worries. So we've got two computers and a printer up here as well. Okay. And then just another great little seating area. If you ever have to work from home, in my mind, this seems like a great place to be able to use.
Right. I work from home anyway, so that works.
A lot of great places in this building you can work from home, so that's cool.
Okay.
Of course, like, the units are great to be able to set up an office space, but if you ever want to, you know, get out of the apartment and kind of get a little change of scenery, a couple different places, you could do that.
Right.
Up here, we've also got our gym. So you'll notice that we have, like, these little signs on the doors. Everything is open with regard to, like, COVID qualifications, but right now there's occupancy limits.
Okay.
So we're kind of just limiting the amount of people in spaces to make sure that people aren't gathering and such. Straight through there, we've got our yoga and spin studio.
Can I go in?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that's mine.
So through here, we've also got the fitness on demand. If you're going to do, like a yoga class or a spin class, you can do that in here. Okay. Just a great space to kind of be able to do a little workout.
I like that.
The gym is available 24/7 as well. So the gym is available 24/7, first come, first serve. We're going to make a right and head through the gym there.
Okay.
This is our little cardio center, and then as you walk, So you do have a fully furnished one bed, one bath apartment home that's rentable. So if you, we allow our residents to rent that for their guests. So if you ever have like family or friends come to stay and you want to put them in their own spot, you've kind of got a place to be able to do that.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Yeah.
So how much does that rent for?
It's $250 a night.
Okay.
So I'm going to take you guys all the way up to the top. We'll check out the rest of the amenities are up there. That's where our pool deck is. We've got a couple amenity spaces up there.
Okay.
And then we'll go down and see the unit right after that.
Gotcha.
So the four elevators that we see here are only four elevators in the building, but they do access each floor level.
Okay.
The one that we're actually about to get into is our freight elevator. Yeah, no problem. We've got our pool deck up here. You've got barbecue grills on the right-hand side. And then you've got a bar here with a television over here on the left. And then you've got the cabanas on both sides.
Wow.
It's a really great
place
to enjoy.
Right. See, this is one of the nicer apartments that I've seen out of like all of them I've been looking at.
Really?
Yeah, and all of them were like higher. And I'm like, what? Oh my gosh. Right.
Yeah, it's a beautiful community. Jesus. It's absolutely beautiful. I feel like no matter what time of day or what weather, when you're up here. This area that we're about to walk through now, so where this door is and where this door is, this is what we consider our upper lounge.
Okay.
So this is a rentable space.
Oh, wow.
If you ever want to, like, host an event or anything, you'd be able to rent this space alone.
Wow.
And that is the doors over there open up to, like, that little pool area, so it's a great space just to be able to enjoy if you don't have a birthday party or something.
Right.
Otherwise, it's available for first come, first serve.
Ooh, wee. Look how, oh, Jesus.
Nice and tall.
Exactly.
Pretty good ways up here.
Exactly.
And then through here, we've just got a few other seating areas to be able to enjoy. Like I mentioned, if you wanted to work from home, a lot of people have been doing that up here.
Okay.
You do have Wi-Fi you can connect to, so really great space if you ever wanted to be able to just enjoy it or get some work done or bring some friends up.
Okay, so question. This part right here, are we able to rent this part or just
the just that little space
okay.
over there?
Okay.
Everything else is available for us comfort.
Well, I don't know that many people anyway. I was just wondering. Yeah. Oh my gosh, yes. I love this.
I know, it's gorgeous.
I cannot wait to see the twos.
I know. They really, the two bedrooms are amazing, like I mentioned, just because of those windows.
Right, and that's
not
one
just,
thing.
But
yeah.
A big part. The one bedrooms are really great too. This is our 1F floor plan.
Okay.
Cool features about this one. You've got two walk-in closets in this one bedroom, and then you've also got the tub and the stand-up shower.
Oh, gosh.
I want to make sure to mention the interiors are a little bit different depending on what floor level you're on.
Okay.
So all of the odd floor levels have these darker cabinets with a white countertop.
Okay.
And all of the even floor levels have, like, the white cabinets with, like, a gray countertop. It's all beautiful and standard. They're just a little different color schemes.
Gotcha.
Yeah. But yeah, feel free to turn anything out if you guys want to pop out on the balcony, open any closet doors, windows.
Oh, Jesus. Look at this closet. You can put a bed in here.
Something, yeah, two of them.
Yeah, that is one.
So, oh, this is the one there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and this is walk in too.
Oh, yeah, that's why it's kind of fun.
Yeah. Okay. All right. If it was just me, I could do this.
Right.
Now I probably still want a two bedroom.
Well, at least you kind of get an idea for like the interior and stuff, you know.
Right. Whoo! 37. Look. Oh. I wish COVID wasn't happening. I'd be over there now.
Okay, guys. So we just not finished. We've been finished at the apartment. We're trying to find some more, but everybody want to be late. You got to make a appointment. You got to make a appointment. So we ain't go. Anyway, we're about to go to the mall after we leave here. Right now, we at the cooking pot to try some Egusi soup and fufu. I'm kind of scared. No disrespect. I'm just saying. I'm a little nervous. But we're going to see what it's about. Oh, God. Okay, y'all. So stay tuned. Okay, you guys. So we got some fufu.
It's called mashed potato fufu.
This is if we want beef or if we want chicken.
Come on, so you can try to get it.
I know we ain't.
Dang it. I told you it was hot.
She should have gave us it.
Okay, so this is what the fufu looks like.
Y'all, and let me go ahead and make a disclaimer. We are not picking on anybody's culture or anything.
It's just,
this is just new to us.
If I don't like it, that ain't my fault.
It's not my fault.
It's not bad, it's spicy as heck though.
For real.
Oh no, the aftertaste is not bad. So this is a no-go.
Okay, guys, so this is the start of a Vloggy vlog, but I want to show y'all what I had picked up from Sephora and Ulta not too long ago, but I've been waiting to use this on my house. So I got this Fenty Beauty foundation in the color 390. And then I went to Ulta. That was all I got from Sephora, by the way. I went to Ulta. I got this makeup brush set. Like that. I got a bath bomb. A Savage Bomb. I got some, what was this? A lip oil. I got some Juvia's Place concealer. And this is in the shade. What shade was this? 13. Then I got some bath salt, like, to relax. I need to do that tonight. Another one is a mineral bath salt. It's called Dream Away. Some African black soap for my face. Y'all don't mind all that. Some prep mist for your face. Some more concealer. And this one is, oh, no, this is the foundation. Shoot, I told a lie. This is in Rio 430. And I also got another foundation in Nairobi in 410. I don't know which one because you know you can't trust the phone right now. I got another eyebrow pencil and that was all. And I just got those with my gift cards I got for Christmas, but I'm about to do my makeup and then we're about to go see some apartments. So
okay guys, so now I am downtown in a city, about to go inside and look at these apartments, these condos, whatever you want to call them.
You gonna hit that little car.
Anyway, so I'm about to go inside to look at this place. And then I'm gonna go look at another one at 4:30. It's 3:30, so I'm looking at one. Then the other one is like actually right over there, back there. So I will talk to y'all in a few and yeah.
Okay, y'all, so we are at the place. Nah, I just went back to go get the car. Cause we was on the whole other side. So I'm walking down here. He went to get a car. I was like, go get the car now. It's freezing. And I'm about to go in. It's so cold, y'all. I'm gonna talk to y'all when we get inside cause it's freezing. I can't do this.
I know some places they said I can't do this. Am I able to pay up like a certain amount of rent?
Yeah, So we can only take
two.
Okay.
I know one place told me that, but I was looking at another company and they were saying you can pay the whole year up if you want. I was like, that sounds good to me. He can tell you, I'll be in the kitchen cooking all the time.
Right.
Like, I love
your flat glass top.
I know, I was looking
the,
at
the range.
Yes. I like that.
You have some bar stools here. That way you can make a show out of your cooking.
Exactly. Okay.
Closet there for some extra storage.
I'm going to need it.
Okay. We've got your open living room. And okay. We also have a designated dining area here, which is super cool. So if you have that dining table, don't get rid of it for anyone.
Got you. Yes.
And if not, I have seen people do kind of like a little reading nook in this area.
Okay.
So you get a lot of sunlight. You see like a lot of above and everything.
Yeah. See, I'll probably just put a desk over here for everything.
Cool office space beside the reading area or an extension to your living room.
Right. Now, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
I know you were saying the maintenance fee is included.
Yeah.
Now, with that, will they be able to take this up a little bit or they can't?
Probably.
Okay.
Yeah, I can see a problem with
that. I'm like, I'm only 5'2", and my head is about to hit it.
Yeah, we can definitely take it up a couple.
Okay.
It's no problem.
Oh, okay. That's
fine. You've got a balcony right off of your living room as well.
Sorry, I'm not getting your face in it. I know some people are like, I don't want to be on that.
Now, again, we do have a couple other ones that are this layout, but with different views and things like
okay.
that.
Okay.
This one has an inner community view.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to step in this car. It's freezing out there. Okay, yeah, I like it.
Here you go. We just in the living room.
Right. And I'm already like, sign me up today.
So in here, we've got your guest bathroom, okay. The deep soaking tub, and you also have these spa-like sinks here.
Oh, yeah.
So you and your guests feel like they're going to be living in a resort when they come to visit you.
Right. I like the detachment.
Across the way there is your second bedroom or guest bedroom.
Okay.
And even your guest bedroom has a nice big walk-in closet.
Right. Oh, okay. I'm looking at the balcony saying, right. Oh, yeah.
You were trying to take this space to...
No, where Mo gonna be? Where's Ziggy gonna be?
You'll
pull
that
closet
on the
closet.
No, I wouldn't.
Oh, no, you got two closets. You said I got two?
Mm-hmm.
What?
So in here is your master bedroom with attached master bathroom. So in here, my favorite part of it. This is my walk-in shower. The 5-3-tiered shower head. Yeah. It is basically a human car wash.
Right.
You've got the water that comes out above.
Out of each part.
The middle and below.
Hey, she about to say sign her.
Right.
You've also got the double vanity in here.
Right. Look at this thing.
For you.
What?
No, we're a hotel.
No, well, look.
Down here, that's one of your closets. So this has tons of shoes. Shoes, hats, accessories. Linens, whatever you got,
right.
You can put them on display.
And the sad part about it is I'll probably still need more room for my shoes.
And then you still have a huge walk-in closet in here as well.
Jesus Christ.
For you.
Right. Oh,
all
my God.
All the nice finishing touches. And then a huge bedroom with those nice big floor-to-ceiling windows.
I'm about to cry. I'm about to cry.
And of course, the shades that are on
all
these,
yeah,
they come with it. Which you can certainly do if you want to do like more shades or things like that. You can certainly hang those. It's no problem.
Well.
our gym. Now, currently, because of COVID, we do have every other one blocked off.
Gotcha.
And it is open only during business hours. That way, we kind of monitor and make sure there's not too many people in here at once.
Right.
Just so we can social distance and all that.
Okay.
But typically, it would be open 24/7.
Okay.
You wouldn't have to have an appointment or anything like that. We got tons of party equipment, like one of our treadmills.
Need it.
Peloton bikes.
Need it.
We do a live class, ellipticals.
Okay. Can I walk down there,
Steve? Yeah.
Okay.
We've got the deadlifts, the Ninja Warrior machine. We have the mirror as well. I don't know if you see those commercials. So those are super cool.
Okay. I like it. Oh, there's a wash and dryer. Mm. Moo Moo need all of this.
Do you guys have any initial questions about the unit or the property right off the bat?
No.
Okay.
Not really. I just now made some dinner. I made salmon, shrimp, Alfredo noodles. We got Hawaiian rolls and we got broccoli. I'm gonna show y'all the plate right there. Jesus. Excuse me. Anyway, thanks. So if y'all want a tutorial on that, let me know. Is it good? Don't lie for the camera.
It was.
I feel like you're lying. I'm gonna taste it. But yeah. My little salmon on the end got a little burnt, but it's okay. So, yeah. Okay, guys. So, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. My voice has been hoarse like the past.
Yeah.
Yeah, for the past
Mama.
2 days. Huh?
Yeah.
The bath?
Yeah.
Okay. But, yeah, I'm just right now in the tub with Moo Moo. We are taking a bath together. If you have, like, if you're a mom and you have a girl, y'all know, like, these times are precious.
Yeah.
Your hands?
Yeah, Mama.
Huh?
Yeah.
Your hands?
No.
But yeah, so I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I did kind of choose a place.
No.
Huh?
Oh.
Huh?
Come here.
Okay, hold on 1 second, okay? Okay. But yeah, you blinking at me?
Yeah.
Y'all gotta see her do that. I will show y'all, but y'all know. You gotta be naked to get in the bathtub. We got some little perverts over here. My belly, thank you. But yeah, y'all, like I was saying, I did kind of choose a place, but it really wasn't one of those that I showed y'all in this video. But I do want y'all to let me know which one is y'all, stop, baby. Which one is y'all's favorite? Huh?
My hair.
This ain't your hair, this is my hair.
Yeah.
Anyways, y'all, like I was saying, I want y'all to let me know what was y'all's favorite. But I hope y'all enjoyed the vlog. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And until next time, which will be probably tomorrow, because I got another video already filmed partially. So yeah, like I said, until tomorrow or the next day, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. And stay blessed, never stressed. Peace.